Welcome back, my dear children of class 6, to our e-learning class. Now we will have some sort of revision work today. And we will do the revision work from the first chapter of our English grammar book, that is the sentences. Now we have already come to know the definition of a sentence. A sentence means a group of words which makes a complete sense. It is known as a sentence. And we have also seen that a sentence must have certain features. For example, a sentence must start with a capital letter. Then, the next feature is a sentence must end with a punctuation mark. It can be full stop for imperative sentences and declarative sentences. It can be question mark for interrogative sentences and mark of exclamation for exclamatory sentences. Next, we know that a sentence must have a subject and a predicate. Subject and predicate. Next, the most important feature is that a sentence must have a finite verb. We know that the verb is like the heart of the sentence. Without the verb, a sentence does not have any existence. Now, what is finite verb? We know that the verb which changes with the change in subject and the change in tense, it is known as a finite verb. For example, if I write, I go to school. So, which is the verb here? Go. Now, if I change the subject from I to he, how the verb will get changed? It will get, should I write, he go to school? Should I write? If I write, then it is wrong. No. So, what we should be writing? He goes to school. So, you can see the change from go to goes. Why? Because the subject is getting changed from I to he. Again, if I change the tense, I go to school, this is simple present tense. If I want to say it in the past tense, so what I will write? I will write, I went to school. So, we can see that the go is getting changed to went when I am talking about the simple past tense. This is simple present and this is simple past. So, when it is simple present, I go to school. When it is simple past, I went to school. So, we have seen the features of sentences. Now we also know that there are four different kinds of sentences. First one is declarative sentence. Second one is interrogative sentence. Third one is imperative sentence. And fourth is the exclamatory sentence. So what we know about the declarative sentence, it is a statement. It is some sort of information. The cow eats grass. And it must get completed with a full stop. And here we are getting some sort of information. We are declaring something. Like for example, I went to school. This is also a declarative sentence. So some sort of declaration, some sort of statement, some sort of information which I am putting forward. Not I am putting in, I want to say. Next one is interrogative sentence. When I want to ask something to somebody, it is known as interrogative sentence and it must get completed with a question mark. Otherwise, it is wrong. Not only for this one, if you are just completing a sentence without a punctuation mark, the whole sentence is wrong. Punctuation matters a lot for these sentences. Then we are having imperative sentence. If we want to order, advise, request, or instruct or command, at that time we must be using imperative sentences like get away or get out from my class or get in, stand straight. These are all imperative sentences. Here we know that the subject you, it is implied. It is not written, we have to understand, because it is implied. And imperative sentences can be used only when the speaker can see the person spoken to. And the fourth one, we are having exclamatory sentences. That means sudden emotions, sudden astonishment, sudden sadness, or strong feelings we express with these exclamatory sentences, and they must get completed with a mark of exclamation. So children, we have just tried to do some sort of revision work from this chapter, the sentences. I hope that it will be quite beneficial for you. So again, we will meet from another chapter. We will do the revision work next time. Okay, bye.